Greetings. Thank you, Brother Merlin, for your comment. It is certainly a new argument to me. Mohammed is mentioned in the Bible texts in the second line of John 5:43. I am come in my Father's name, and you receive me not. If another shall come in his name, him you will receive. I know this was said to Pharisees, but it does have other applications. Let's take a look at John 5:43 in context first, and then critically analyze the possibility that this refers to Muhammad. John 5:39, you diligently search the scriptures because you think to have eternal life in them, and these are they bearing witness concerning me. And you will not come to me that you might have life. I do not accept glory from men, but I know you, that you do not have the love of God in yourselves. I have come in my Father's name, and you do not receive me. If another comes in his own name, you will receive him. How can you believe when you receive glory from one another, and you do not seek the glory that is from the one and only God? I think the first thing to notice, brother, is that this is part of a larger statement. Jesus is, as you mentioned, speaking to Pharisees. Our first obligation to God is to understand the clear text before we look for hidden meanings. And nothing in the context mentions this is a parable to be used for hidden instruction or revelation. Jesus is debating why the Pharisees will not receive his words. Tacitly, Jesus brings God's words, which should arguably have more authority. Yet the Pharisees have a contradictory behavior. They will accept the words of a man speaking his own ideas for and from himself. But they will not accept the words of God brought by Jesus. So the plain meaning is not the mention of the future prophet, but a discussion or argument why the Pharisees rejected Jesus' message. Let's now examine your claim of a secondary meaning that one particular phrase foretells Muhammad. If another comes in his own name, you will receive him. I see several critical problems with attempting to interpret this as mention of Muhammad, brother. One, when Jesus says you will receive him, Jesus is talking to the Pharisees, Jews, Jewish leaders. The fair and honest treatment of the text is that you, the Pharisees, will be the ones receiving the one speaking in his own name. It is about the same as honestly interpreting the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, being given to you, the disciples. The Comforter, the Holy Spirit, was in fact given to you, the disciples, on the day of Pentecost, only 50 days after the resurrection. There is no rational, and I would say proper, reason to think this suddenly means, the original verse, the Arab people 600 years from now, receiving Muhammad speaking in his own name. In that case, it would be reasonable to expect Jesus would not use you, which carries the immediate connotation of the Pharisees. And I accept the reality that many, many things Jesus said to the disciples readily apply to all Christians later. I believe that concept and doctrine readily comes from the following. John 17:20. I am not asking on behalf of them alone, speaking of the disciples, but also on behalf of those who will believe in me through their message. And that prayer by Jesus also has a specific context and intent. Jesus did not pray, "Let every word I say apply to every human, believer and unbeliever alike." So to the point, I do not think the argument to the Pharisees, who were unbelievers, extends to all men. But there is a second problem, which is much more important. If another comes in his own name. Stating this fact of a man coming in his own name completely violates the fact Muhammad claimed to come in Allah's name. Think about that. The one they would accept must come claiming to speak for himself. And if Muhammad is supposed to be this speaker, how does that possibly fit? Logically, the only support one can offer is to claim Jesus knew Muhammad was speaking only for himself, but claiming he spoke for Allah. But that just makes my head hurt trying to twist it into Mohammedan contortions. To simplify the explanation, Jesus said a man coming in his own name, meaning claiming to speak for himself, would be accepted. Muhammad claimed the exact opposite, to not speak for himself. So Muhammad cannot possibly be this person the Jews would accept. And a third and final refutation I would deign to offer is acceptance. Jesus said they would accept, or will accept, the man who came speaking in his own name. But the Jews, whether as a whole or as the Pharisees only, did not accept Muhammad. If this were speaking of Muhammad, they would have accepted him as Jesus foretold. So, brother, in Mythbusters vernacular, I'd have to say this claim is busted. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.